Confusing as heck. That's how the president of the Main Street Palm Springs Association describes all the rules that local businesses are now trying to navigate as they reopen. They just met with city officials to get more clarity. I spoke today with Joy Brown Meredith.
Joy, thanks for joining us.
Glad to. Thanks for inviting me.
Of course. Let me ask you, how has this crisis impacted so many of our businesses, including yours?
Well, this has certainly been a troubled time for all businesses, independent businesses, even some bigger stores. But downtown, you know, it has been very troubling. Of course, we have a large amount of our customers are tourists, and that has basically been put to a halt altogether. So I think that a lot of people are going to have to really rethink their businesses a bit. One positive thing for my own business, Crystal Fantasy Downtown, was that it finally encouraged me to redesign my website. I've only redesigned it once since 1998. And, you know, you just have to start thinking out of the box and thinking of different things that you could do and be more creative than ever, really. So, you know, today I'd say that most of the businesses have reopened. Maybe some of the eateries haven't quite yet because they have a lot of protocols that they have to figure out there.
You mentioned the reopening that's now happening for many stores. How has that been so far?
It's joyful downtown right now. I think, you know, people are very happy to have the opportunity to reopen. And I think that those that, you know, really plan for it ahead of time are able to open much sooner than the others. Some people, I think, were still wringing their hands about it and not really putting a plan in place, which is certainly what we were recommending, is get your plan in place, because we never were going to know exactly what day we were going to be able to reopen. When the governor allowed the curbside, though, that too, it was like, you know, on a Thursday, he said you could open with curbside. Well, we didn't even really know exactly what that meant, but it was basically at that moment that you would be able to. So I just think that, you know, it's important to really pay attention to the cues that are coming from the governor. Of course, the governor could put out one set of plans, and then the county has the opportunity to put out something more rigid, and then the cities have the opportunity to put out something more rigid than that. You know, and I think that gives the local authorities the opportunity to really better understand our own community and what the needs are. The fact is, like in our town, we have a lot of older people like me, and a lot of other people that are maybe immunodeficient in different ways. And so, you know, it's just important to remember that we have to take care of our community.
You mentioned the fact that there are different rules from the state, from the county, and from the cities. Is it confusing at all for the businesses to navigate, okay, which rules do I follow and how?
Confusing as heck for people. Definitely. I mean, you know, so this is what we've really asked for the city to do, and they're going to be having a meeting. We had our Main Street Board meeting yesterday, and it included the city manager, the mayor, and the police chief. We're just trying to figure out what exactly the rules are so that we could communicate that out to the merchants downtown. You know, one thing that makes Main Street different than most other organizations is that you don't have to be a member for us to have you in our communication circle. We're not about that. We don't have staff. We don't have to pay for an office or anything like that. So our job is really just business owners helping business owners figure out daily business. And it's never been more important, really, than this time like this. The city is planning a meeting similar to what we had yesterday for all the businesses, just so that people could understand what's what. Like, you know, I think for a lot of people, they, you know, when they heard from the county or from the Dave, whoever it was there, I can't even remember, but that, oh, it was the county, that masks were suggested but not required, but our city does in fact require masks or face coverings within any open business in Palm Springs. And, you know, we just got to get our footing here and make sure that we are doing things safely and taking care of our community.
Joy, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for inviting me. That was very nice of you. Nice talking to you.